Grace and peace from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Over the 9 years that I've been bishop, I've been in hundreds of our churches. And very often on Sunday morning, I visit with people in Sunday school classes or in adult forum faith education classes. And eventually the topic turns to why is it that the church isn't like it used to be? And I get questions like, where are the young people? What is the future of our church? Where have all the people gone? Will our church have to close? And generally, these questions kind of imply and go towards, Bishop, what are you going to do? And I've talked with groups of people about the changes in our church and in our culture. And often stories and anecdotes from the church help me to understand and wonder, what is the future of things? We are in a time of change. So we have two presentations for you today around this topic. One is from a pastor in our synod, Pastor Chris Sear, and one is a voice from outside of our synod, Pastor Priscilla Paris Austin. Both are speaking to this time of change in our church. And our theme for the assembly this year is Journey with Jesus. Journey is a beautiful metaphor of life and in our scriptures as well. The image speaks to a movement, not necessarily a destination. It's not a destination, but a process, and it is shaped by the people we meet along the way as we experience even unexpected hospitality. Although there are countless stories in our scriptures about journeys, Abram following God's command to go to the Holy Land, the Exodus story, the journey into and out of exile, Jesus's journeys through the Holy Land, and then Paul's journeys in the early church. Yet we'll hear the story today of a journey of the disciples on the road to Emmaus as our key text for our time together. And we'll hear that whole story in just a little bit from Pastor Paris Austin. Pastor Paris Austin will also speak about the liminal time. I first learned about liminal spaces when I was studying ecology in college. Liminal spaces are edge spaces between one environment and another environment, where the ocean meets the shore, where the forest meets the field. These are places where organisms are surviving in a rapidly changing environment, moisture one moment and drying heat in the next. These kinds of environments are really challenging, and organisms have to be adaptable and resilient to survive in these kind of liminal spaces, in the place of change. In many ways, as we journey with Christ, we as a church are in this liminal moment of change, this edge moment, leaving one environment and journeying to a new place. It is the questions that I hear so often when I visit in all of our churches. What does the future look like? Why are things so different today? Can we endure this changing world as the church? It was this year that one of our pastors sent me his doctoral thesis on what is happening in the church at this time. And not a kind of general paper about mainline denominations, but really very specifically about what's occurring in the ELCA and in the Lower Susquehanna Synod in particular. Dr. Chris Sear, who is receiving his PhD today from Catholic University, did in-depth research on what's happening in the church, both by looking at studies and statistics in the ELCA and then specifically in our synod. And then he did in-depth interviews with a random group of people who left Lower Susquehanna Synod congregations to gain insight into why they left and where they went. To better understand the issues that you've been asking me about Sunday mornings. Some of the very things that I suspected were confirmed, but as with all things, there was much to learn from this research. So I asked Pastor Chris to summarize his over 200-page theses down into a brief presentation for the whole synod. And so that is what we will share today. If you're interested, I'm certain we could make his incomplete thesis available for you. The purpose of his presentation is not to offer easy solutions. There are no easy solutions. The purpose is to better explain what's happening in the church and to begin a conversation in each of our congregations, a conversation about the reality of our current life in the church, and to foster a conversation about our collective future as the church. In the Lutheran tradition that proclaims the good news of Jesus Christ in this time and place. Then we're going to turn to Pastor Paris Austin for a theological reflection and to share stories from her journey with Jesus, to imagine how Jesus is shaping the church in new ways. Again, her stories are not solutions to be adopted, but rather a glimpse into what journeying with Jesus looks like in one place in the ELCA. I pray that you find these presentations thought-provoking and engaging as you consider your own journey with Jesus. Following Pastor Paris Austin's presentations, she will be available for questions. But let us begin now with Pastor Chris Sear.